Similarly, we can have area 2 here, and it will be DLS and DLZ. DLS, DLZ here, and it will be in phi unit vector. So we can write for DLS, we can write DS, and for the DLZ, DZ. So this will be equal to DS and DZ here. And this is in the phi unit vector. Similarly, we can write another area element, and that is dA3. This is equal to dl phi dlz, dl phi and dlz, and this will be in the S unit vector. And this is equal, dl phi is equal to S d phi dz, S d phi dz here, and this is in the S unit vector. We can find area from any one of them, and this will give us the right result. Similarly, we can calculate the volume element, and is we were having in the three-dimensional dx, dy, dz in the Cartesian coordinates. So here we will have d tau equal to dls dl phi and dlz. So d tau is equal dls ds s d phi dz. So we are having s ds d phi and dz here. While they are running from these limits, so we can find area, or we can find the volume of a cylinder with the help of these. Similarly, we can do those conversions like writing x in terms of s phi and z and so on, y in terms of phi and s, and z is the third dimension, so it is the same as it is. Let me do calculate first the area and the volume of a cylinder. So this is, for example, we do calculate this one. Let's say we are having this thing equal, let's say the area of a cylinder, and the area of a cylinder will be an integral on dA, and let me write dA1 here with ds and s d phi. So this is s ds, means this is dA1 I am calculating, so this is equal to s ds d phi, and this is equal, integration is on 2, so we will have 2 integral on s, and s running from 0 to some defined radius, let's say it is r, and s ds here, then integral from 0 to 2 pi, and this is d phi. So this is equal, this will become s square by 2. So s square by 2 from 0 to r, and this will be 2 pi. And this is equal to, this is equal, 2 will cancel with 2 here, and r square in phi. So this gives us phi times r squared. And this gives us the area of the base of the cylinder, pi r square. Pi r square is the area of the circle, means the base of the cylinder will give us this one. Similarly, when I will do calculate the ds and the dz here, means another area, then it will give the surface area of this cylinder, because the phi is, this is the role of the phi, that it moves on the base, makes the base of the circle or cylinder, and then we are rising it z distance up in order to make this a complete cylinder. So is an assignment you can practice on these, that what kind of area it will give you and in which direction it will be. Here this phi r square, it is in the, we can see here that it is in the z unit vector. So z unit vector means it will be either the top of it in z unit vector or minus z unit vector, the bottom face here. So it is the area of the base of the cylinder. Then we can have the surface area of the cylinder by taking the other area elements along S or along phi unit vector. Similarly, the volume can be calculated. The volume is equal to d tau. And d tau, then this is equal to SDS. So we are having 0 to r in SDS here, then integral from 0 to 2 pi, and this is d pi, then integral from 0 to z here, we are not taking the minus z here, but from some defined distance z, and it is dz here. So what it will give us, let me calculate directly here. This will give us s square by 2. And putting the limit r in 0, it will be just r square by 2. So we will have r square by 2 here. Then from d pi, we will have 2 pi. And from this, we will have z here. So it will, 2 will cancel, and it will make pi r square and z. So pi r square and z will make, means it will make pi r square is the base, and then we will raise by height z, and it will give us the volume of a cylinder. So this is equal to the volume of a cylinder, pi r square times the length of this cylinder. So from here, from, let's say now we can convert the unit vectors. Let's say this is equation 1 and this is equation 2 here. If I do multiply this with cos phi and this with the sine phi, and then I do subtract, then it will become positive and x will remain, and then we will have this thing. So let's do it. Now we multiply equation 1 by cos phi. So multiplying 1 by cos phi. So this will be equal cos phi, and s unit vector is equal to cos square phi, and the x unit vector, and plus sine phi and cos phi, and the y unit vector, and multiply equation 2, multiply equation 2 by sine phi. So it will make sine phi, phi unit vector, sine phi in phi unit vector equals minus sine phi cos phi, minus sine square phi in x unit vector, plus sine phi cos phi, sine phi cos phi in y unit vector. And let's subtract these two. So what will cause the subtraction? This sign will become minus, this sign will become plus, and this sign will become minus. So we will have the cancellation of the y unit vector terms, then this cos square plus sin square phi, this will come out to be equal to 1, and this will give us the x unit vector. X unit vector is equal to cos phi and s cos phi in s unit vector minus sine phi in y unit vector. Similarly, if I do multiply equation 1 by sine phi and equation 2 by cos phi, then what will be the result? The result will be that this will become sine phi. So sine phi and cos phi, then this will become sine square. This cos phi, so minus means this I will multiply with the cos phi, so minus cos phi and sin phi and cos phi, so these two will cancel and then add them, so they will cancel, and here this will become cos square phi, so sin square and cos square phi will become 1, so it means that we will have to add them up in order to have this cancellation, and from here I can write that the y unit vector will be equal, the y unit vector will be equal, if I multiply this with the sine phi and this with the cos phi, so sine phi in s sine phi in s unit vector plus cos phi in y unit vector. And the z unit vector is, we know that it will come out to be the same as z unit vector. Similarly, the other things will also be true here, as we are having x dot x unit vector equals y dot y unit vector and equals z dot z unit vector equals 1. And this is the normalization of the basis vector. Similarly, x dot y unit vector equals y dot z unit vector equals z unit vector dot x unit vector, and this is equal to 0. The orthonormality of our functions, of our unit vectors, so this thing is true for here as well, that this will come out to be 1. We can check here. X unit vector with x unit vector, so it will become the inner component will multiply, and before that we will have to prove this one as well, that s unit vector dot s unit vector is equal to phi unit vector dot phi unit vector and equals z unit vector dot z unit vector, and they are equal to 1. Similarly, the s unit vector dot phi unit vector dot z unit vector is equal to z unit vector dot s unit vector, and they are equal to 0. And similarly, the things are true for the, as we can write x cross y unit vector equal to z unit vector, we can write the things for the cross product here as well. We can prove this one, that s unit vector dot s unit vector is equal to 1. So look here, this is, let's say, let me do calculate this one, s dot s here, s dot s, so the inner component x unit vector dot x unit vector will become 1, and it will become cos square phi, and then it will become sine square phi, so sine square phi, and this is equal to 1, we know. Similarly here, the phi unit vector, so for the phi unit vector, minus sine phi with minus sine phi will become sine square phi, cos phi with cos phi cos square phi, and this will also come out to be equal to 1 here, and z unit vector dot z unit vector, so z dot z unit vector, we already know that it is equal to 1 here. Similarly, you can practice on the cross product of them, on the dot product of them. You can calculate the area elements here for dA2, dA3, and if your calculation comes out to be wrong, are not matching with the values that we generally have, then you can write me in the comment and I will provide you with the calculations. So this is for the cylindrical polar coordinates. Similarly, with the cylindrical polar coordinates, we can convert the in the form of gradient in cylindrical polar coordinates. We can convert to the divergence, can convert to the curl. We with this, our calculations will be easier in the sphere, in the cylindrical polar coordinates. So this is all about the cylindrical polar coordinates, and in your book the gradient, the divergence and the curl, while as well as the Laplacian, have been written here. You can derive these results. This will boost your confidence in doing such calculation, although it will take more time, but it will give you confidence to do these things. Thank you.